Yo, Ofidyan is a god.
Ofidyan's awesome. He's a good reptile and he was a hell of a good host. Alright. Oh, the overhead.
Really fast.
Yelling in his face. He's yelling in his face, trying to get that damage. Oh wow, he gets crossed up. Ofidyan.
Took it.
Visible.
36, that's a kilo. I need a brick to miss my 3 flow. I'm in love just like me, no, no. Busting shots like me, oh. Free my homies, not the CEO. And not the judge, not my PO, no. All this I'm like me, no. What a whip, I'm like me, no.
Upstream, about to get this going. Just needed a second here. Let me know if you can hear me good. This time I moved the mic a lot closer. That way, hopefully it's a little easier to hear me, and I also turned down the game volume some. Hey, S Scribble, thanks for the follow. Really appreciate it, man. But yeah, this time the volume of the game shouldn't overwhelm my voice, so it won't sound like I'm just mumbling the whole time. Because that was not good. Even though I probably need a better microphone. This will do for now. Okay, so we got Olympian. The Olympic Sub-Zero. How you guys doing? Just got off work. Come on, man, pick your character. Sub-Zero is a good, of course, you know, it's one of the best matchups against reptiles. So sometimes I'll see people move their cursor over and they'll be looking to, hey man, how's it going? What's up, Mexican? What's up, please? Man, how's it going, guys? Miss you guys. I haven't got to play MKX like as much as I want to at all. This would be fun though, playing a little bit of online ranked. Then I'm gonna get something to eat, and then I'm probably gonna play some more a little bit later tonight. Alright. Standard Devor pressure here. Gotta block the puddle, but then that's plus. I didn't need to press anything. Dang it. Yeah, you can just armor. So then we're gonna hook him up with this deal. I stepped out of his wake-up range just in case he were to wake up with the little stingers. That's one good thing about the Reptile Devor matchup, is a lot of times on knockdowns you can freely get a force ball out and stay out of their range of those stingers. Make something happen. Well, it's super laggy. I don't know what is going on here. We spiked up to like 400. Okay. I feel like I should dispute this. Yeah. It's really hard to move right now. Oh my days. That's alright. Yeah, he's good block. I'll get him next round. That's fine. I'd hope so. Play a lot of KI now, huh? Yeah, KI is really awesome. My teammate Sleep, F3 Sleep, he's like a really good KI player. And he, you know, taught me a little bit about Fulgore, and I was kind of hooked. I'm thinking, I really want to play KI too. One, four, up. Alright. Goes for it. Oh, dang. I can't believe my legs still got clipped. Yeah, this guy's got some decent divorce. Good respect, but he didn't punish me. There we go. That's where he's going to put the puddle. Try to do his low poke. Most divorces do. That string is so good. Yep, a little bit of. I kind of thought he was gonna stutter right there. Of course, you know, I'm not gonna respect him. So, good stuff though. That was a really good war up there. They agreed to play me. I got a lot. Yeah, Sleep's a really nice guy. Sleep's real name is Darnell. He's like a brother to me. He's a great teacher and he's very humble. He's a great person to get into KI with, or to be involved with in the
faction battle.
Sorry, got like some text messages. Sleep's just a great player to play KI with and to know in the community, because he does a lot for the community. He's very helpful.
Katana.
Okay, mystery size off. Did you pick up a sponsor or something? That's awesome, man. If you did, congrats.
Round one, fight.
Okay, so we got Zoner Katanas, mournful. You know how that goes. I like to actually play a little bit of zoning with them and see what they do. I'll end combos with spit, and get them out here, and then, wow. I didn't think he would do that. Okay. Yeah. We'll play the zone war. Yeah, people, if they let you get a force ball out and you dash up, they like to just press buttons whenever they feel that threat incoming, you know.
Fight.
Oh yeah, that's a punish. I'm not sure why he ended with that. That must have been an input error. I'm pretty sure that's punishable in all variations of Katana, so. If you guys see what I'm doing here, I'm doing this thing where I forward dash up after slide enders. And the reason I'm doing it is because sometimes if I have meter, whenever I dash up, I'll do a invisibility, and if they wake up and they try to do like if for some reason famous team, one of our members of ESL in the top 8. That's awesome, man. But what I was saying is, like, the thing about dash up invisibility is it has armor on it, of course, and it makes it to where they, if they wake up throw, or if they, even if they tech roll wake up throw, it covers that option, and it also covers most wake up attacks in the game. Even if the wake up attack is two hits, it still will cover it because you can do block, like you can do invisibility and hold block, and you'll be able to block whatever they are doing, and then you'll punish it because typically most wake up attacks are unsafe. But what's going to happen with this setup is sometimes people are going to straight up whiff their wake up attack. Like if Jax does wake up dash punch, it's just going to like whiff 100%. So it's pretty great. It's great for those one hit wake ups. And it works on every wake up in the game, including Reptile Slide as well. Who is this? Kilimanjaro? Cicada player? I like to start off testing people sometimes with that meter burn slide. Mainly just because a lot of people aren't ready, or they're trying to jump back or scoot back or something, and then I just get another bar meter anyway and start with some damage. Sometimes it helps, you can get a force ball out first thing. It is, you know, it's super risky, of course. This guy's getting kind of frustrated, I can tell. Yeah. Okay, there he goes. He's already starting teleports. Wow, I pressed it. This is so laggy. That was one of those where you press forward 4-1 and you get one, standing one by itself.
Round two, fight.
Nice. That's right. Tried to armor there, but didn't come out. Whatever, like, coming out later here. This kind of sucks because he has the meter advantage, so I need to be really careful about what I do. Most likely, I'm going to have to... You have to deal with the pressure a little bit. Try to stay plus, you know. I think he's, you know, he's got me. Yeah. I don't know. I couldn't really get my moves to come out. Like, I couldn't get my my armor to come out, so. Takeda, boys. I gotta get a little more warmed up. Yeah, he's got a lot of like plus stuff, and he kind of can put a mix up in there. I think it's like a little bit more reactable. I just couldn't get the armor to come out when I wanted it to. I was trying to do armor claw right after that second whip, but I couldn't make it happen, so. It's all good. It's just online. Online boy. This guy had like 2,000 wins, so he's probably pretty good. This, and he plays Smoke, and Smoke's a good character. Even with the nerfs to the Triborg family, I think he's still a really good character.
Round one, fight.
Oh, nice. Neutral jump punch. Good way to start it out. Oh, doesn't respect the 4-2. It's pretty good. A lot of times, like, you can tell when somebody doesn't know the Reptile matchup. Oh, that's an overhead. Ugh. You can tell when somebody doesn't know the Reptile matchup because when you do back 2 and they, like, try to press a button that maybe isn't their fastest button, or they're trying to, like move and you catch them with 4-2, that's just like a clear sign that they don't know. And then they're gonna think that you know Reptile's cheap. They're gonna go, oh my god, why is he crossing his overhead? But it's really not cheap. It's only plus 1, and you can backdash and then you won't get hit by the 4-2, or you could just do your fastest normal and typically beat him out. That's what I do to other reptile players. Like in the mirror, I'll just do, I'll just start up 4-4. Okay. It's kind of laggy here. we're getting to some stable connections, maybe. What's up, Vigilante? Reptile. Back dash before he does a 50-50 and his vortex. You know what, Justin? You're gonna have to help me out because I don't know much about Shirayu. We only played I only played like Ronin and Lashers, really. I mean, I played some Shirayu online, of course, but it's like they're always just meh. Like they're all right, so whatever. His name is Crawling Shadow.
Faction battle.
Crawling Shadow. Oh yeah, I know who Crawling Shadow is. Mexican, are you from Texas? I think you said you're from like Virginia or something, I forgot. But yeah. Alright, this guy maybe, oh wow, 1700 wins. You know he's gonna be good. Do you guys like marquee matchups? Because me and Treadmill is the match of the night. And he's playing Smoke, okay. Smoke, out of all the ninjas, I think out of the robot ninjas, I think that he looks the coolest. I'm at Smoke, but I'll help you with Shirai. Yeah, man, you gotta help me with that for sure. But part of that was just, it was like kind of lag spiking. And you know, I like the purple too. The purple's pretty cool. Nice. Oh, missed his combo up. Alright, he's still got some good stuff going. Yep. Try to do the tech. He didn't want to wake up though. It's fine. People start respecting you so much when you're invisible. So then, you kind of can do what you want. Like you go invisible and they start like over-respecting your ability.
Round two, fight.
Vigilante, too busy with college. Well, hey man, that's good. That's a good thing. Being busy with college, getting your music stuff that you're doing, that's more important for sure. There's always going to be a Mortal Kombat game. You got to remember that. You know, you're going to be done with school one day and playing Mortal Kombat 12 and just think like, oh man, this game is great. Like, there's always gonna be games, so I wouldn't worry about it. You miss a year, no big deal. Especially for NRS titles, because you know everything changes so much. You know, even for Street Fighter, really. For Street Fighter, there's a lot of people that don't like 5 that really liked 4, and vice versa, so. Oh yeah, caught me with the overhead. Is that gonna be enough? Oh, goes into the vortex. Oh, yep, I think he got me. Good. Alright. He knows what's up. Those thousands of wins don't mean absolutely nothing, at least. We're seeing that he knows what he's doing. He knows how to block Reptile a little bit. Oh. Got caught with shenanigans. You can always armor a backdash anytime you see a Reptile go invisible now. Except for standing 4. If you block standing 4 into invisibility, you gotta hold that, because the next part he's gonna do is true. Oh! Damn, I got too impatient. I really wanted to kill him with 4-4 slide. It's alright, he's kinda just giving me meter now. Block this. Oh! I thought that was gonna be a punish. Yeah. What was that? Why would you go into that? No more. Pretty much changed the way you play. Actually, not that bad.
Reptile wins.
I don't know. Smoke's invisibility doesn't seem to be used very often at all. Honestly, like I would use that a lot if I could figure out a way to make that really good. I would try to use it a lot. man, Rodriguez. 600 wins. That's probably more than me, right? Oh, he didn't want to go. Okay. Well.
Faction battle.
Who is this? Is MK my... Yeah, I would say Mortal Kombat's still my favorite fighter. It's just... Mortal Kombat's just kind of in my blood, so... I think Mortal Kombat is just always going to be my favorite fighter, but... I do really enjoy other ones. Even the ones that people don't really know about as much, like... Bloody Roar. I really like Bloody Roar. I like a lot of stuff, really. Oh man, it's starting to rain outside. Sorry guys, I'm close to a window, so I'm gonna close that. It's probably pretty loud. Beat this guy up real quick. Free Zamboni rides. Yeah, okay. That's cool. Actually, after this, oh, he's done. Okay. Well, after this, I'm going to be right back. I'm going to get something to drink. Close that window. Don't worry, I won't be more than like 5 seconds, hopefully. 2 seconds. That's what my European friends say. Alright. Be right back, guys.
Yo, Ofidyan is a f***ing god.
Ofidyan's awesome. He's a good reptile and he was a fellow good host.
Right. Oh, the overhead.
Really fast.
Yelling in his face. He's yelling in his face, trying to get that damage. He didn't wake up yet.
Yeah.
He wasn't wake up. He didn't. Oh, wow. He gets crossed up. Ofidyan.
As far as I can tell, I played the Jax matchup a lot. I feel like it's slightly in Jax's favor a little bit for a few reasons. I mean, he gets more out of his mix-ups, definitely gets more damage, of course. But he beats me in a lot of areas on the stage that I can't beat him. One of the best things I've got going for me against him is my down 4 and my forward 2. Those typically are the best tools against him. But it's kind of hard, like with Jax, if he gets in your face, it's just, you gotta guess, and I may start using only Alien against Jax. Yeah, I figured he'd go for something. I think he went for the gotcha grab. See this tech right there, that if he would have done something, he would have been getting hit, so that's why that works really well.
Could you not see me?
Round 2, fight!
Trade and some zoning, that's fine. Oh. At least he knows a little bit about the reptile matchup. Normally Ominous would duck right there. Yeah. Oh, see, yeah, that, you can stay out of the range of that and poke it, kind of. That was another, he keeps doing wake up gotcha grab. There's a low. Okay. Yeah, that was in case he was just neutral ducking since I grabbed him last time. Let's see. Yeah, he's done. This is gonna die from meaty chip. Okay. He was pretty good though. Like he definitely knew how to block Reptile at least, so that's good. A lot slower than I expected, like for the time that it is right now when everyone's getting off work, I figured it would be finding people pretty quickly.
Faction battle.
We got people.
Reptile. Katana.
Katana. Always a pleasure, right? Always a pleasure with Katana. Throwing fans, you're working your way over. She's just one of the more relaxing characters, I'm sure. To put it nicely. See? I mean, he's not doing anything, so it's like... It's not really working out, but it is good for a lot of people online that like to poke or like to wake up. Oh, I've never seen that string before. It kind of caught me off guard. Yeah. Oh, no fan. Normally after that string they throw the fan. Dang it. It's kind of laggy. That's alright. I need to just need to conserve my meter a little bit more. Get used to this. This speed, whenever it's up in 100 like this, it's like, wow. Good luck. Good luck having consistency. Oh, but see, he fell for the back two into the 4-2-1. It's kind of nice that you can do it on block on some people, but other people, you can't get used to that. It'll blow you up. Here we go, here's the fan toss at the end of the block stream. From a certain distance, Reptile can just punish that. Yeah, that's enough.
Smell of desperation.
Final round.
Oh, what's up, Stubbs? Exclusives? Exclusive Stubbs viewership? Oh man, he woke up. Oh, fan toss. You know you can't do that. Not that close. Sometimes they'll burn meter on it, though. And then you gotta block it. You gotta hold it. Okay. Looking good here. He's doing good. Nice. Missed up the jump in, of course. Got glitched out on the wake up. I don't know why the slide's not hitting. It's alright, though. One more spit exchange, or that ball's gonna hit him. Yep.
Yep.
Stubbs, I miss you, man. You gotta come over sometime.
Reptile,
we gotta play these fighters, Stubbs. Oh, you know what'd be tight though is if you got the new Monster Hunter game, Monster Hunter Generations. You got a 3DS or something? That's gonna be. A lot of fun, I think. I'm gonna try to play that. I'm trying to get a device so that I can stream it, because to stream from a Nintendo DS, you have to have like a certain capture card modded into it in order for it to work. And one of the only places you can get it is from Japan, really. Okay, we got a Leatherface. I really don't know much about Leatherface. You're... Well, Stubbs, if you ever get it back from your kids, it's definitely a great game. I know, like, you know, they need to play it more than me, of course. Get your kids. We enjoyed Game Boy Color, right? We already had our time. Alright, this guy looks like he's going to be a little bit too respectful here. Especially with this invisibility, I'm feeling like with invisible, he's going to have to do whatever I want. Yeah, he's just sitting here holding block, so that's never good. Don't want to get grabbed too much. And, oh yeah, Leatherface kind of can get, I guess, I would say he can be zoned out a little bit, especially by Reptile, because with Reptile zoning, it's easier to handle some people because of the different speeds that you can throw everything. Now, sometimes do like a slow force ball, then run up and do something, or do like a spit, you never know, whatever. Just spit, keep him away. Okay, just jump right over it, and see, the problem is he jumped right over it, but then he had to take some pressure whenever he was landing, because I had already recovered. So it's kind of the same, it's like a similar strat that my brother does with his tank. So I'm getting x-rayed. Yeah, my brother Aya, he'll do, you know, shooting fireballs, and then eventually he spaces you out with the fireballs just perfectly to get you to jump at the exact point that he wants, and then he runs up and does 4-4 with Liu Kang. And of course, you guys know, if you get hit by 4-4 with Liu Kang, even on block, that's like when he's starting his pressure and going ham. So but Liu Kang, I mean, I know he got nerfed a little bit. I think he's still good, but he's just a shell of what he used to be. That's for sure. Kind of like Tremor, but not in the same way. Tremor's fixes are helpful, but they're just... He's definitely just not near as good as he used to be. Tremor used to be top tier, and now he's probably mid or mid-low. I don't know. I don't know what people think of Tremor. It seems like he's not played that much anymore. I don't even see DJT play him anymore. Alright, Boracho. Oh wait, from Mortal Kombat Deception. I think he's pretty good. Oh, that wake up caught me from pretty far away. I think he's pretty good though. Like in this game, he's up there. Like he's like higher end of mid, or maybe even closer to the top. The damage he can do is pretty ridiculous, even still. Like even with the adjustments, he still does a ridiculous amount of damage. Gets caught. Yeah. Oop. Nice grab. And he put me in the corner, so that's good. Of course, I'm reckless and just waking up with Reptilian Dash. Waking up with Slide. I'm just playing like, I don't care. I know those are overheads. I guess I didn't block it. Oh, I'll try to go for the sweep. Ellie, I do like the sweeps are a lot safer now. Oh, what? Yes, I'm dead. I'm so dead. Why didn't the 4-4-1 come out? Yeah. If I would have got what I wanted on the other side, it would have been better, but whatever. Reptile wins. Fatality. You do see quite a bit of DLC characters, it seems like, whenever you're playing ranked. A lot of them are trying to feel, maybe they're just trying to feel out their character in ranked, because that's, I just feel like ranked is how you get your matches the fastest. Like player match, I mean, it's, I guess it's pretty good since you can rematch and play each other over and over again. But like, what's wrong with just like, you know, playing a new person? This guy has 2,100 wins. Like, this guy's probably really good. So you still get to play like good people in ranked. I mean, I know it's only one match, but I feel like I get more variety matchups. Even though, as I say that, I'm getting Boricho again. Oh man, Boricho. This time it's Drunken Master though, so. I hear that Drunken Master is maybe the best. No,
I sensed he is not.
Drunken Master is the variation where you got to make sure that you continually drink, and if you don't drink, then he'll fall over or something like that. For most Borichos, I like to try to zone him out. Got me with this. Restand. Oh yeah, see, he knows what he's doing. Here we go. Getting the damage. 37% in the corner. The low to the tick throw. Oh, but then there was. That was him throwing up because you gotta make sure that you drink. Try to run under, get 4-4. Overhead. Yeah. But that's not punishable here. Maybe it is. Stream, is that punishable? Or I should stream with like low into the overhead. Yeah. See, I kind of know. I know a little bit about Boricho's strings, but oh, there it goes. I know a little bit about it, but I don't play it. I don't really play Boricho enough. The main way that I beat Boricho players is just by zoning them out, which I'm gonna have to do to this guy. Honestly, I don't want to fight him up close. He looks like he knows a little bit about what he's doing, so I'm just gonna send him full screen and zone him. Oh yeah, he's hurting from that because he needs to get in and do damage and stuff. There goes the drinks. Whoa! I could have sworn I went down, but every time I'm on these like 100 MS or 100 plus MS, it seems like I don't go down. Wow, getting all kinds of stuff I don't want. Front flips. Yeah, try to get the jump punch. Oh, there it is. Throwing up. Gotta make sure to... It's kind of backwards, right? Gotta make sure to keep drinking so that you don't throw up. That doesn't make any sense. Yeah, he is. Stubs. This Boricho knows what's up. Look, he even knows Reptile matchup. He knows how to block me. He doesn't want to respect me though when I'm invisible. Let's poke. Dang it. No, I guess it's not punishable. I don't know, guys. That had to have been punishable. There we go. Good throw. This guy. Good grab. With that low into the tick throw setup. I'm gonna try to just throw him full screen so I can zone him and see if this works out. Oh, nice. He knows it. Yeah, I knew he would try to grab me. Whenever there's an exchange like that, oh man, why are you doing that? Whenever there's an exchange like that, for some reason people... Yeah. JJ, for sure, like the moves that he does are kind of... They've always been kind of stupid to me. They seem like they don't... Somewhat seem like they have a place in MK, but since MK is kind of campy and quirky, I guess they kind of do. To each his own, yeah. Sure, yeah. I mean, it's really up to somebody else. And good match. He made you work for it. Yeah, but yeah. Yeah, that was a good Boricho player. he had, what, 2,000 something wins? He was just probably a good player in general. He probably plays another character, and he's really good with them.
Reptile, alien.
This guy is going alien conjurer, which I don't see ever. Conjurer alien is like the one that, you know, has the setups, but nobody really plays it. Oh, alien, yeah, I guess he kind of bends down like Blanca Stubbs. He kind of like, the way he moves around is kind of like Blanca, but he's actually a really good character, Stubbs. I should teach him to you because I really, really like him. I think he's one of those characters that he's great for like just learning the game because he has really good normals that just beat out a lot of other things. No, he does have range. You gotta take in mind that he's not super great in your face in all variations. Sarcotany is, of course, and Acidic he is, but in this variation you gotta be a little more careful because it's like setup based. This guy's just gonna respect me, it looks like. Oh no. That wake up, I know it is punishable if you do block it, but you kinda have to guess. Is it gonna be wake up overhead flip, or is it gonna be the wake up tail? You don't know, lower overhead. I guess it's better just to kinda hit him away from you and try your best to avoid it. Try to stay out. So, like a claw ender, and then stepping back. Oh. Got caught. Oh, nice. That might have been like a setup thing he was trying to do. I couldn't tell. But this character does have setups. I just don't know what they are. Like, it's obvious that he does. They're built in. I just don't know exactly what they look like yet. He's still very new. Okay, my slide didn't come out. Anytime something doesn't come out, I look down at the ping and I see 100 something and I'm like, oh. Yeah. Took a risk with the wake up slide. He could have blocked it and still probably punished me. But, you know, sometimes you gotta do it. That was enough time that I got on the run. Okay, nice.
Reptile wins.
Yeah. Yeah, I know, Khaleesi. Yeah, I mean, like, I had a friend that really, he really wanted Nightwing as well. Nightwing was like Nightwolf was like his favorite character. And we thought that, you know, sure, he'll be in it for sure. But, I mean, whenever, especially when the storyline's going on and other people that are supposed to be dead are, they're like still in the game. So we're like, well, then of course Nightwolf can still make it in. Nobody really dies in Mortal Kombat, right? It's like, whatever. You die, you go to the Nether Realm, you escape the Nether Realm and come back. You got this guy again. I think this is the guy I just played. Yeah. Oh, now he's gonna go Jason. This was the guy I just played, I'm pretty sure. Sindel, Cabal, Fusion. Yeah. I know, yeah, Justin, I know. Like, Rain would have been so cool. There's a lot of people that wanted Rain.
Round one, fight!
Okay. This guy's starting off. Okay, got the armor. So we chose Slasher, Jason. Jason is good now, for sure. Jason got the buffs to make him really good. He got a new normal. Slasher can throw the machetes even faster now, so the zoning's even better. Yeah, I backdashed after that slide. That way I can stay back, throw a fourth ball, and avoid all wake-ups. You know, the strats.
You smell of desperation.
Round two, fight.
Let's see, okay. So now maybe his zoning is gonna start. Though I think that was the new move. That Johnny Cage knee thing that he just did right there. That's the new move. Oh, good armor. Oh, yeah. I'm not sure what happened there in that exchange. It looked like he got me with the jump in, but I guess he didn't. Just trying to get him with knee slides. Oh, finally block run. Okay. That's gonna be it, yeah. Really wish Acid Puddle was worthwhile. Reptile wins. Don't you guys? Yeah, the machete is a mid, actually, yeah, it is. Which reptile variation is the best? I heard Nimble is the best. Bounty, yeah, like, Nimble has its advantages, Deceptive has its advantages, and Noxious does as well. Honestly, I still think Deceptive might be the best for more matchups, only on paper. But Nimble still has matchups that it's better for than Deceptive. It's just that Deceptive's pressure is so good if you want it to be. Well, it's good, but it's also bad, especially since they nerfed it. Like, you're taking a huge risk burning meter in your pressure to try to continue doing something, but it does catch a lot of people, and also it's great for gaps. When there's gaps in people's strings, you can use Deceptive to not have to deal with them and also be safe, instead of armoring a gap on accident where they baited it. Here's Tremor, speak of the devil. So, yeah, I mean, I think that Deceptive might be the best still, but Nimble, the conversions are crazy, like, it's more damage, and Noxious is still really good too, because it's really safe, and it baits out a lot of things because of poison gas. There we go. This guy knows the reptile matchup a little bit, so I'm going to go a little harder on him and do 4-4-1 slides, and then change it up sometimes and not do that. Nimble boys, yep. Mexican will tell you all about Sizon. He'll tell you all about Nimble Reptile. He's like one of the best, if not the best, Nimble Reptile out there. Oh, look at this guy. Good block. Oh, nice little combo. That was pretty good. That was going to be a cool combo. You got to forgive online, because he probably gets that offline. There's a gap, of course, right there. Can't do stuff like that. Oh, wow. Stutter in 2-1. I'm not sure why you would ever want to stutter 2-1. You probably didn't mean to do that. Okay, he's going to try to do some zoning. Oh, no, I wanted to block that so bad, but I didn't. I tried to run up and block it, honestly. That guy was good, though. That was actually a pretty decent trimmer. And I mean, for me, I like playing Crystalline Trimmer just because it seems like it has cool ideas. It has good tools, good ideas. Like, just make it fun for me. The style is crazy. Yeah, I mean, Nimble, you can do some gimmicky stuff that's actually pretty fun. Like, you can do stuff like 4-4-1-2 activate Nimble with meter, and then like backdash, and people will typically try to poke, and then you can get forward too. So that's pretty funny. But mainly what Nimble comes down to is converting off of your forward four, which is the knee thing, the 9-frame mid. You want to convert off of it better while you have Nimble. And you'll probably want setups. Found a 55% and a reversal, 51%. Dang. My race will return. Nice. Size off. I meant with the tech. Always coming up with cool Nimble stuff. I love your channel too, man. I love your work. You always have good stuff. Dude, this casting costume, I don't think I've ever seen it before. Maybe. Yeah, we get punished. Okay, now he's feeling the pressure. Oh, I thought he might flip. There it is. Just randomly, see that? They're so scared, they just flip. Like, I was way, way back there, trying to stay out of the range of it and watch for the diving glow kick, and then he just flip. Burns his bar meter. Yep. people can't wait, they gotta press the buttons. That was in case you woke up. I did back three there into the meter burn block. Oh wow, I thought I held it long enough. Just trying to hold the block for the wake up window. Wow. Do not go air to air against anybody when you're reptile. There we go. Okay. That lab work though, yeah. Yeah, man, Reptile and Nimble does 50s for sure. They're not always, the 50s and Nimble aren't always super practical, but you can get them, you know. It definitely will happen in a match, especially a match where someone doesn't really know how to fight Reptile. Like, if they don't know the Reptile matchup, you can do Nimble setups where you knock them down in the corner and do a mix-up where you're going to convert for 50%. But if they wake up, then you'll get hit, of course. I mean, it's not, nothing's guaranteed with Nimble unless you got it out of, unless you got like a 4-4 or a force ball. Those are definitely guaranteed combo conversions. And I mean stuff like 1-2 force ball and back 1 down 4 force ball. Because then you can get that neutral jump punch and go into basilisk conversions. Hey man, I don't mind. You can promote your channel on mine. I'll tell them what it is. They should see your stuff. It's really good. Doing back one, down four, EX Nimble activate. Yeah, man. Yeah, Bounty, you should check out his channel. Especially since you're learning Nimble Reptile. Here we go. We got a Noxus right here. But since you're learning Nimble, you should check out Sizoth's channel, because it definitely will get you up to speed. Oh, nice wake up. Yeah, I just backdashed because I thought he might try something. I don't know what the wake up is going to be. Oh, caught me. Good, yeah, good stuff. Noxus is so cool because the rolls were reversed right here. I'd just be standing there letting him hit me, because I'd build meter and he was gonna die if he had that amount of health left. Oh yeah, see, if you don't properly punish 4-2-1 grab, then a lot of times people are late, so you can get that armored claw. It's not something that I highly recommend doing, like, especially in a tournament, but for some reason online it works a lot. Okay, this guy, he's getting pretty antsy. He's liking the... Okay, see, he knows. As a Reptile player, he knows. And he didn't even try to do 4-4. He was just like, you know what, I blocked that back too. 4-2 is probably coming out. He's gonna let me go. Don't let me take a shot like this. I like, oh man, that's amazing. Yeah, here's the deceptive pressure part that I'm talking about. You can do stuff like that. 4-4-1-2, invisibility, down 3, and then throw them or go for a mix up or whatever. Something that really works is 4-4-1-2, go invisible, down 3, and then do back 1, down 4, and that's how you can get back 1, down 4 starters to happen, like, pretty regularly. Not gonna lie. In the chat who does not understand Reptile. Man, well, I will... Justin, I will tell you as much as you need to know about Reptile. I play on PS4 and Xbox One. Faction. Yeah, Justin, I'll when we play online sometime, I'll just try to tell you more about his frame data. I feel like I haven't actually done that with you before. I feel like I told you what was punishable, but I didn't actually like tell you everything about it. All right, this guy's Scorpion main, probably. That's what his thumbnail was, right? Oh no, what's he got? Predator. Okay. Hishkutin. Zoner one. Yeah, Sizoth Reptile. You guys should check it out. If you guys are looking especially for some nimble stuff, check out Sizoth Reptile on YouTube for sure. That's my boy. All right. So you're gonna have a hard time zoning against Predator, so you want to stay in on him. That's what I'm gonna try to do anyway, unless he really doesn't know what he's doing. I'm gonna try to. My goal is to stay in and hopefully not deal with so much lag. Oh my gosh, this is bad. Stay in on him, and even on pressure, you can do certain things where you throw a force ball out and then run up and continue pressure because his wake up is so slow that you'll break his armor if you do it right on the particular knockdowns. I probably should make a video about it. It's pretty good tech. Ooh. Good block. There's a huge gap there that when you're doing the force ball, it could have punished me with something. There's a little bit of anti-wake up tech there. Reverse his wake up. Oh, yeah. Reversed it, but I jumped a little too early. That's alright, he's pretty much dead. Yeah, he's dead now. Yeah, I have Xbox too. I mean, now I don't really play Xbox because, as far as I know, and I haven't competed in ESL yet this season, but as far as I know, they don't do it on Xbox anymore. They're doing the actual Pro League on PS4, and you can do like a Challenger League, which is nothing. It's just like for fun or something. So, you don't know, maybe win like keychains for prizes. I don't really know, but it's not real. And I think there's not a real version for Xbox. There's only the Challenger Cup on Xbox. And then there's the real thing is on PS4 now. So, I guess that's, you know, it's a good time to have a PS4 because that's great for ESL. Before, it was like you wanted to have an Xbox because that's how you played ESL. Luckily, my little brother just gave me his because he was like, hey, I don't need it. I have a PS4. I don't have room for anything else. He was going to college and, you know, dorm life. Oh. Sub-Zero, right? Round one. Grandmaster, too, so good choice. Oh, good block. But he's a little too respectful, and that's... sometimes a sign that it's you can wait and then armor. Like if you wait in someone's face, it's super respectful. Wait the block for just a second and then armor. Pressing something, it's crazy. They're pressing stuff like always the wrong time. See that jump in was horrible. That jump in guaranteed either my chip or me killing him. Like you don't want to just jump over force balls. Especially at certain ranges, it's always a bad idea to choose to just jump over it. You slide, yep, you slide. This is catching him because he knows the reptile matchup a little bit. Most Sub-Zeros do because they counterpick reptile with Sub-Zero. Yep, I shouldn't have thrown that force ball there. That was really bad. I was hoping that he would be trying to come in at this point since his health is so low, that's why I threw it. But I guess he's still content with doing a little bit of zoning out here. Oh, I missed the punish there. You can easily punish that with 4-4. Here's deceptive pressure. See what deceptive pressure, people, they still kind of freak out when you do it to them. And you get to do a lot of free stuff like 4-4-1-2 down 3 or 4-4-1-2 invisibility jump, whatever. Alright, Mexican, I'll see you later. Hitting the lab. Yeah, man. Thanks for watching the stream. Or just keep watching. I'm going to stream for just a little bit longer. And then I'm going to get something to eat. Because I got to eat some dinner. Same guy. 1,600 wins, too, so he's good. He's definitely a good player. Sub-Zero again. Okay, so this is gonna be the true test. This is 2 out of 3s. See, ranked has 2 out of 3s. It's got him. What do you mean, Bounty? Like, with the pressure and Deceptive? Forward full run 2, invisibility? That's... Yeah, that's... What's up? Alright. I'm sure... Okay, I'm kind of playing dumb right here. I'm being the aggressor. I don't need to be, but sometimes it's fun to see. I'm gonna kind of see what he does if I'm the aggressor. Of course, jumping into clones, not the best idea. He's got the clones out. Jumping in general in the Sub-Zero matchup is not the best idea because back 2 seems to take you out of the air like an anti-air anyway. So it's kind of like, don't. Yep. Jump. I thought he might try to jump out of the corner. Some people do that as soon as they get put in it. I want to pressure him in the corner too, but like, it's kind of dangerous just going to the corner against Sub-Zero because if the roll switches, then you might lose the entire match. So I gotta get out of here. I'm gonna. Oh, good break to keep me in the corner. Good way to low profile that. Caught me with that thing. I'm not gonna jump anymore. I'm gonna try my hardest not to jump. Down 1 is one of your best tools to deal with Sub-Zero's clones. Not down 3, surprisingly. Down 1 is better to deal with clones than down 3 is. Alright. See, now he's at a point where he is going to try to zone me some. And I don't know why. He shouldn't zone me. Whenever you have the life lead, it's not smart in any... I mean, whenever you don't have the life lead, it's not really smart in any game to be zoning. What's up, Harry? Fighting this Sub-Zero right now. Getting frozen, you know.
Sub-Zero, boys.
Grandmaster subs. Reptile's best matchup. okay, yeah. That was a bad jump on his part. He... Oh man, he could have gone with the overhead and that would have beat me up. Is that not punishable? That low, the last one that ends with a low sweep, I guess. I mean, I tried to punish him. Yeah. Okay. It's -9. That's why it's hard to punish before, but I should just like slid it. Next time I know, I'll just I'll dash or slide it. Oh, the overhead. Oh, he's getting antsy, throwing pokes out. Now he's gonna die from zoning. See, you're pretty much guaranteed dead. At that range, if he would have slid, he would have slid right in front of my face and kind of got punished from whiffing the slide. Or he was gonna just take the chip from the force balls and end up dying that way. My own is the same as my name on here. PSN. Cool. Yeah. Oh, man. Yeah, stream chat's over here. Hard work and dedication. Yeah, the pressure, weight. Is his back 3 into invisibility safe and guaranteed? Yeah, it's, yeah, Bounty. Back 3 invisibility doesn't have a gap. It's safe, of course, because you can do back 3 invisibility and block, but, it's... Well, actually, I think it does have a gap. But... It's kind of like there's also a gap between like special moves from pokes, and a lot of people don't do anything about it. Like, you know, if you do down 3 claw with Reptile, there's technically a gap, but nobody like actually tries to armor that. Like, I run up to people, I'll do down 3 claw, and sometimes the down 3 hits, sometimes it doesn't, but either way, claw ends up coming out without being interrupted. So a lot of guys going Noxus for some reason. Wonder why. Mainly play on Mystery Silent. Yeah, Noxus is still good for sure. It's still a variation that I like. It's still my favorite, but I don't think it's the best by any means. Okay, so this Reptile player, he's jump happy. But if you jump first, you know that typically is better. Okay, he's got set up for the force ball. Thought he was gonna slide, so I jumped. Okay. Whiff slides, gotta love it. Approaching 100 ms. there's that block pressure with Deceptive. 4-4 invisibility. I mean, 4-4-1-2 invisibility. Down 3. Pretty much get whatever you want after that. Bad jump. You jump right into the range of 4-4.
Round 2. Fight.
Oh, good flip there. Gonna get some damage out of that. You kind of dropped the end of it. That wasn't a safe jump out of the corner. He could have anti-aired me with like standing one or something, but with this kind of connection, I doubt that's going to be happening. Oh man, I thought I could jump out of the 4-2. If you time it a little late, you can jump out of those, but if the reptile is pretty tight with his timing, a lot of times you'll get caught with that 4-2. Oh, good block, but no actual punish to the gap there, force block. You can actually just jump over a pile and punish him. You don't even need to use armor. Like, I could see right there, I just did 4-4-1 to punish it. You shouldn't be letting Reptile do, like, force balls like that in your face. Used to be in C88. Yeah, man, C88's awesome. I know some C88 guys, like Big Milk, Beef Supreme. Those are C88 guys. I think, was Griffin C88 at some point?
I think he was.
Ominous, he's Chaotic Ominous right now, but Ominous, or Griffin, is Griffin's his name. He I think, used to be C88, but for some reason he isn't anymore.
Faction battle.
That's another Reptile player. Look at that, 2,000 wins. 2,220 wins, that's a lot. This guy's probably, this might be that high ranked reptile that I saw. There's like a, there was a reptile that was top ranked on PSN, and there's one.
He said Crawling Shadow made top 8 PSN.
Oh, this last week? Maybe, I don't know. I didn't watch, I was like working all day Sunday, so I didn't like compete it, watching it, watch it, follow it, nothing, I don't know, anything like. And look, another guy going Noxious. It's like all the reptiles today. It used to be everyone played Deceptive, and now not as many people play Deceptive because of the Deceptive nerf. They're like, oh man, it's no good anymore. So now they're just like, well, I don't know where to go. I'm playing, and they're back to playing Noxious and Nimble and stuff. And really, all the variations are like, they're all good. It's Reptile's like just general tools that he has, like his strings and his buttons. They're really good. So it's not a variation that's gonna like really help you. It's knowing Reptile in general. Like he's gonna have to be the character that you can just understand the spacing and learn the matchup like that. Yep, got caught with the overhead. Oh, he's doing force ball pressure to me in the corner. Good setup. Yeah, this dude knows what's up. Oh, stayed low, that was good. Oh, couldn't get the punish. Getting up there on the MS. Jump, Griffin didn't need to do that. Yep. Well, I mean, it was pretty good. Yeah, whenever you go invisible and you start stuttering strings, nobody can, like, nobody really knows what to do. They start getting just scared and they don't want to poke. I mean, I wouldn't want to poke either because, like, the reptile player may be finishing the string, so when he's doing that, it's like, you don't know. You could be, especially in the corner, could be back into another full combo just for letting off, just for thinking, oh, he might be stuttering right there. Although poking, even if Reptile's blocking, poking is good because even when you poke, he's gonna lose his invisibility. The stream was lit. talking about ESL. I'm gonna have to watch it. I haven't even watched all of last week's ESL. I think I got like halfway through it, and then I started doing something else. Kenshi. Never see Kenshi. Kenshi is a character that a lot of people just, they say he's bad, they don't want to play him, they don't want to, you know, try to learn anything. Can you do double Basilisk? I don't even know what that is. Size off, you're gonna have to, that's your tech, man. You got some new stuff, I don't know. So, Kenjutsu, Harry, you play Kenjutsu, right? You know.
Yeah.
What's the deal with this? Oh, random reflect. I think he wants to reflect these force balls, but he's really just... Oh, wake up, forward dash. That's probably this guy. Yeah, I don't know. He's got a plenty of meter though. I mean, he's probably smart to save it for the next round. Let it carry over. I would do the same thing if I had that much of a life deficit. Oh yeah, especially being in the corner right there. Easily could have done more damage. Wow. It feels so bad. It doesn't even say it so bad. It feels like spotty. It's spiking. Two Basilisks in one combo. I think I know what you're talking about. Like, it's like Basilisk and you're doing a combo. Like, the force ball hits on, and then the cooldown is already over, so you get to do Basilisk again. It's like kind of situational. Yeah. I think I know what you're talking about. But I haven't actually done it, like, in a match. Yeah, me and, Dark 55 here, probably gonna go get something to eat pretty soon, and we gotta go get that Dark Souls 3. Are any of you guys playing that? Yeah, bro, it's pretty tricky. Yeah. Dark Souls 3. I think I played this guy earlier. 2,000 wins. Dark Souls is like a third person. I don't know, what would you call it? It's like a third person. Is it an RPG? I guess so. It's like an action RPG.
That's an action RPG.
And the reason I think it's cool. Hack and slash. I mean, it's more difficult. Like, it's not like a God of War where you can just like get in there and like press buttons and you win. It's more of a strategy. You know, it's known for being somewhat difficult. All right, so this guy goes Scorpion. I'm not sure if you played Scorpion before. I think you did. Yeah, you don't see Inferno much at all. This guy probably lagged out plenty of wins. Yeah, that was knee slide. Keeps me safe from an armored reversal if he's gonna do that.
Yeah, he even got that. But I guess it's not.
Round two.
Fight. I mean, you can't always believe what it says down here in the ping. Oh man, why didn't I stay down? I know to stay down. Hey. No, you just stay down. You just stay down against Scorpion because you. Oh man, I should have been holding block because I could have blocked that. What's the mix up? Oh wait, still going. Oh man, I was holding down and didn't react. Yeah, early on, yeah, I remember. Man, I couldn't finish my combo, I dropped it. I see. Oh, we got Mr. Pretty and Pink in here to tell you that you suck, Harry.
Oh, is he saying like Dark Souls?
He said Dark.
No, is he saying like Dark Souls?
Oh,
like
Dark are you sucks? Saying Dark Souls sucks or Dark 55 sucks?
Dark 55.
You gotta clarify. Yeah. You gotta clarify. We could be talking about two different things here. Mr. Pretty in Pink is Damien and Dick Murphy.
Oh, yeah. I guess it was a double entendre.
Is Dark Souls out yet? Justin, I'm pretty sure Dark Souls is out.
Comes out tonight at midnight.
Nah, Dark 55 here. He sucks. Okay. Made that clear. All right.
I got you. Thank you for clarifying.
Oh, Chiarayu? Yes. Need Chiarayu. Shimmy sham sham. I need this. I need to play this more. I already lost this earlier. America, it comes out tomorrow.
Yeah, it comes out tonight.
Tonight at midnight, then. Good deal. Me and Dark 55 here. Yeah. Me and Dark 55, we got plans. We're going to GameStop. We're going to get our trade-ins. Trade in our old games to try to get some money. You know, 25 cents. Yeah. See if I can. Wow, I cannot land this combo online. All I'm trying to do is down 2-1, 4-1, 2 slide, and every time I try to do the 2-1, I don't get it. Oh yeah, people block that a lot, yeah. Back one down four, it gets blocked a lot more now. But some people I think are just staying down because they don't know their up top matchup. Like, sometimes I give them too much respect. Hold on, this guy is, he's got some combos, okay. Dude, he's got me down a lot of life. Yeah, I couldn't get the punish, yeah. So I was trying to punish him 4-4. Yeah. That was bad. Horrible punish here. Oh, good block. Nice poke, too. Yeah, I figured I could jump. He's like super respectful. And then as soon as I say that, he like lets off a force ball right in the face. Oh, that's the setup. Let's see. Oh, he could have broke. I'm not sure why he didn't. That setup was, he couldn't have done anything about waking up with that. Because what I did is I ended the combo with slide and then I forward dash, and then at kind of a right timing, you activate invisibility and it has armor. So with that armor, people will be trying to wake up or do whatever. Even if they tech roll wake up, it's not going to work. Their wake up will just hit the armor of the invisibility, or you should be holding block and they should just wake up into your block, and then you can punish their wake up attack. Really, it's great too, because if they don't wake up, then what ends up happening is a lot of people tech roll and then they're holding block, and you just happen to be holding block as well, but you just got done going invisible. And then you press something at the same time they're letting off block to try to press something as well. That's how it works, like offline anyway. Online, it's hard to gauge like what people's tendencies are. Because sometimes it's not really a tendency at all. It's just they're trying to get their moves to come out and it just doesn't come out because it's online. So you don't know exactly what people's tendencies are as much. Hey, thanks Bounty for the follow. Appreciate it. Okay, Sonya. Who in the stream chat doesn't think that Sonya is top 5? If you don't, can you give me 3 good reasons why she's not? Because I wouldn't be able to tell you. I'm just wondering. I think she's top. She's easily top 5. I don't know, that was a weird option he tried to do there. Like, he tried to do neutral jump punch. And he didn't even, it wasn't his advantage, and he just started to do neutral jump punch. Yeah, quick run under, get in the combo. Oh. I don't know if I would have chose to spin my meter right there. That combo wasn't gonna hurt that bad. It was only gonna be like 30s. And he would have had the meter right now. Of course, Sonya doesn't really need her meter. She can just make things happen without it. Okay, oh, this guy's trying to lag me out. Protest match. There, okay, so there's the neutral jump punch. He was waiting. He really wants to just see me whiff 4-4 in his face, and then he wants to punish it. Oh, he could have killed. Okay, good. I was about to say, he better kill me and not just let me stand up and do something. Especially with my meter. Like, since I had meter, it was like, I could use this, but I decided not to, because I'll take care of him this round. Like, he's not going to be able to beat me whenever I meter. Not this much. And look at this invisibility stuff that people are so scared of. Oh, good cloak. Probably shouldn't have stuttered there. I saw that I had him. Yep. All those boys. No problem. Yeah, thanks, man. Seriously. Bounty, thanks. It helps a lot. Like, trying to get some followers. I know I need to stream more consistently, but I'm trying to. I'm gonna try to do it more and try to stream more games too. I recently bought Pokken, so I'm gonna try to play that.
Yeah. Apparently he says, y'all, I'm at work. So I'm peace out for a little. Hey, remember that you are the worst monster.
All right. See ya. See ya, pretty and pink. Thanks for the tips.
That's that Kyle shit.
Just remember.
Just word in and be like, and you suck. And like sign off or something. Yeah. You can't do anything or say anything. He's
sitting
like,
there all happy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I bet he's sitting there just cheesing.
Yeah.
Sub-Zero. Oh.
Are you not entertained?
Jake, I fought a Kenshi earlier.
Dang.
But he chose wrong. He went Kenjutsu. Whoops.
Yeah.
He probably should have gone against Reptile. I feel like Balance is the best, but Possessed is still really good too. Like,
conditions only good for the option for the okay. Zone.
Well, look, he went Balance. Like, see if he uses it correctly. Nice armor already starting off. We got the combos here. Oh, good reflect. Expecting the force ball here. Oh, wow. Just a random. Oh, nice armor. Yep. This is exactly how you do it. You kind of keep Reptile out like that. I think I'm just gonna. He might have. Yeah. Oh no! Now he's getting a little bit. He's trying to. Oh man. I did run. I ran up and I was thinking I would block that, but I guess I didn't press it fast enough. Uh-oh, now he's in the corner. Not so good for Kenshi now. This is not where he wants to be. I know he does have his rising karma, so I have to respect that, but other than that, I think he's trying to do too much. Like, he needs to just poke and then try to get back into his spacing. He shouldn't be trying to do much else. Because Kenshi needs to be full screen away from me. Now he's got plenty of meter. Oh, chose not to do a rising karma. Waited for the gap. Nice. I like it. Online, I like to do 4-4-1-2 force ball, because a lot of people just they get tense, they let off, and then they get hit by the force ball. Alright, here we go. Set up. See what I mean? Didn't matter what he did. He's gonna have to deal with that. And I dropped the combo, which could kill him, but shouldn't kill him with that slide. Okay. That guy played the Kenshi matchup pretty well, though. Honestly, that's like what you want to do. As a Kenshi player, you wanna try to keep Reptile out, and probably use Balanced. That's probably just the best way to go. See what we got next. So far, the character variety today has been pretty good. I've seen it hasn't been like full blown DLC the whole time, but it's been a good amount of both, like DLC and regular, just kind of back and forth. streaming. I'm gonna stream for maybe like 15 more minutes. I think I've been doing it that long. Since like, I think I started at like 5 or something. Okay, we got Sector coming in. Sector, a lot of people don't wanna, they don't wanna think he's as good anymore because of the overall nerfs to the robots. But I still think he's a pretty good character. Like I still think that he's one of the more like well-rounded of the robots. And he can zone pretty good too. Definitely can zone. Oh, he doesn't want to play. Alright. Flawless victory. And got some cereal. What kind? You know I gotta know what kind, because we gotta see if we're on the same level here. Ranked match. People quitting games. Captain Crunch, okay. Captain Crunch, oops, all berries. You know that, you know about that. I mean, I haven't seen that in a while, but that was top tier for sure. Cookie Crisps.
Okay. Yeah. He knows what's yes. up. He got some, he got good taste.
Yeah. You know for sure. You definitely know. Fruity Pebbles, it doesn't matter. I'm more of a Cocoa Pebbles kind of guy. I like the chocolate. I like how the I like how the milk is chocolatey afterwards. It makes me actually want to drink it. Crisps though, Cookie Crisps. You guys know about Golden Crisps. What about that? Is that what it's called, or is it called something else now?
It's Golden Grahams.
Golden Grahams. No, there's like a bear on it. You know, there's like a bear and it's like crispy.
Oh, Golden Crisps are everything. It's the
yeah.
Little
uh-huh. Okay, so see here we got Leatherface. A lot of people do go with the killer variation. You know, I don't really see much of Pretty Lady. I don't see that at all. Yeah, I only see like Killer and the one for Mallet. Yeah, Butcher. Okay, super respectful. Gonna get grabbed for that. That's one for flinching. Yeah, just running straight into the force ball. Nice. No armor. No armor or nothing. Just man, coming at me.
His screen is so funny too.
Yeah. The little noises he makes. Okay, no, again, no armor.
Does that have armor support?
Well, no, like, there's a meter burn version of it that has armor. Oh man, I was trying to uppercut him into the. I was thinking about uppercutting him into the next force ball, but I knew it wouldn't hit as soon as I saw the distance from the wall, so I kind of stopped thinking about it. He did get his x-ray on me, though. You know, that could be a. A total turn in the event. Oh no. People just like to do their x-rays because they think it looks cool, I guess. I don't know. Why would you want to just spend all of your meter like that?
Yeah, no death, no nothing. It was just
what did you miss? man, you didn't miss much. Pretty much just been over here doing deceptive things, you know, 4412 invisibility, the dash up invisibility, it's still working great. Still getting a lot of people. Most people are choosing not even to wake up sometimes on it, and then they're just getting hit by strings that come afterwards because they're like holding block. But that's about it. I'm gonna upload this to YouTube, so it'll be on YouTube and you can just watch all the way through it. Plus, I guess the archive, but those get deleted over time. Even when I told Twitch not to delete some of my stuff, and it still did it, so I kind of was just like, whatever. I'm going to make sure my computer has a copy of this to upload it to YouTube, and that's just the way that I do it. Okay, Kung Lao player. Declined. Maybe he's just starting out. Looks like he doesn't have very many matches played. But I mean, if no matter what, like, I want to play anybody. You know, I don't care who it is. I want to play everybody. Even if somebody's like way better. Like this guy, he has way more wins than me. 1,200. Of course I want to play him, because if I lose, then I learn. I have something to learn, obviously. And then I can like go back and I can watch the video and see what I was getting hit by. That's like the fun part to me. Just like winning the whole time and everybody's getting overwhelmed by your stuff is not like fun to watch over again. Like, you don't want to go back and watch it.
What is this?
What's up, man? What's up, Boyz? Doing good. How about you?
Out of my way.
Just been streaming for maybe like an hour or something. Hour and a half. Trying to get a little bit in before dinner. A little bit of ranked. Oh, wow. Yeah, I thought I was blocking. Who would have thought at 100 MS that you're blocking? Ooh, the overhead stream. Kid Coop. Oh, nice. Good poke. Yeah, he realized that, I'm getting wrecked by not only the netcode, but also by Kid Coop himself. Oh, just throwing out the normal. Throwing it out. You know it's so good. They buffed that. That's Scorpion's 4-2, so cannot convert on the combos. Things are going good. Looking great for me. Yeah. Oh. Yeah, wasted some stamina here. It's not going to kill. What's he going to do? Oh. I tried to block the wake-up window. And then I started trying to get into that meaty chip damage, but didn't hold block long enough. You can punish that. I know you can. You can punish it with rotating dash. There we go. Yeah. It's just whenever you're working at a... Whenever you're flying at 100 MS, you can't really expect everything to come out like it's supposed to. Oh! Stutter, yeah. Oh, with a flash of lightning, you're hit by the overhead. Isn't that insane? Kid Cooper is sitting on his meter this time. Want to get up? Oh, yeah, I'm not gonna let that happen again. I'm holding block for extra seconds now, because I know how this works. Whenever you reach 100 MS, you gotta like make sure that that button is stuck down. Oh, whoa! Just random uppercut, and I missed the whiff punish there. Started the 4-4-1 into the back. Oh my gosh, these combos.
Back to
Oh yeah. Oh man, no whip punish again. Could have just whip punish with reptilian dash or a slide. But I'm not. Oh, who would have thought? Okay, this is his chance to come back here. Oh man, I went. Yeah, I went down. Second part of that's an overhead now. I'm not really used to that yet. They fixed that up. I mean, he...
I guess maybe he was lagging too.
So he was good. He was lagging too, I'm sure. We were both feeling the lag, and this level doesn't help at all. This level probably has, like, lag spikes of its own. Hey, War, I saw some of your new videos, I think I commented on them, but they were pretty awesome. And, oh yeah, I was watching your stream too. Good stuff, man, for sure. Let me know. Well, I think I followed it, so I'll know whenever you go live again. Whoa. More messages below. Johnny. 513. He's got an Onaga icon, but Onaga is not in this game, unfortunately. That would have been a cool DLC character. But I guess Onaga can't really exist without... No, that was 7. Or, yeah, I guess it was 6. Deception, yeah. When Onaga came out, it was... supposedly Reptile's body. It's like a mixture of Onaga's spirit and Reptile's body and the dragon egg that made him what he is. So you can't really have Reptile and have Onaga unless he looks totally different and didn't use Reptile's body. But, you know, as far as the lore goes, he did use Reptile. Oh man, good choice to teleport there, but didn't really get much out of it. Yeah, he blocked the tunnel even when invisible. Wow, I can't believe I got hit by that overhead. This is so laggy. He's doing the business. Oh! Wow, I missed. I could have done a much bigger punish there.
So crazy. He got hit by the overhead and then he was like, oh, go low.
Yeah. Oh man, I didn't know that I reached that far. I guess it does reach pretty far. Oh! Yep. I thought he might step back or backdash or jump back, so I went ahead and let him slide, but at that point, I mean, who cares? Yeah. Oh. Yep. Oh, get the real punish. Here we go. Just standing there. I guess he decided that, you know what, I've already woke up before. Better not do it again. Then, here we go. Right, oh, overhead. This could be it. This could be the turning point. Going into Scorpion Ports. Oh man, the overhead again. For some reason, I'm holding down block and cannot stand up in time. He's gonna get it. The comeback, oh, yep, it's real. But, at least I got my one bar, feeling better. Feeling better about this already. Got a bar and a half. That means a lot to everyone out there. Give us a meter. We can get in. We can convert with damage. Do armor moves.
What is
the usual. Yeah. Right. I mean, I think that there might be certain matchups for Scorpion, probably like one or two, where you can like outzone somebody. And maybe that's the only reason for it. But other than that, oh man, he's got me. Oh man, he missed it. Yeah, could have killed him. Anyway, I wasn't paying attention. Inferno, I guess like.
Reptile wins.
I don't know. I'm trying to think of somebody it could outzone.
It
like,
couldn't outzone anybody. It's not gonna be outzone anybody. That shit is horrible.
It can't outzone.
Like, cause I know what
Stream,
that's supposed
do you
to
guys
be.
Know like what is Inferno good for?
Like, I don't know. I know it's not supposed to be just completely zoning. It's whatever. But like even the zoning in it, it's like you don't want to use it because it's like after they block one overhead, which is very, you know, reactable.
Yeah.
It's like, you know, they get to run back into your face full screen, right?
Yeah.
And if they did a low, you know, cool, you can do it in a combo, but if you miss it, it's full combo punishable. And you can react to the overhead at least. So.
Yeah. Cyber Sub-Zero, alright.
You know, people...
We are getting some very different matchups.
People say, and have said, that Cyber Sub-Zero is, like, dirty. You know what I'm saying? Like, they have some, like, it's really good.
Right. And he really was, like, in the corner.
I'm like, I haven't seen anybody play Cyber Sub-Zero.
Well, now, here's your chance. Here's your chance to see the... possibly the Cyber Sub-Zero of the world. What's his name? JC. Alright. Playing at 100. Wow. Oh yeah, we got slides. We got ice. He's treating him like he's Sub-Zero from or he's the Grandmaster Sub. He is pressing some buttons here, so because of that, he's having to take some damage. Oh, there's the slide tech. doesn't want to wake up again.
I guess, like, if you kick Sub-Zero, you might as well be ready to block him a long time.
Yeah.
It's like you're going to be cold and make sure you block him again. If you're actually important,
yeah. Yep, that was just a great example of tech being used, though. The end combos with slide and then dash up. Do reptilian, or do invisibility, and then done, right? They wake up. Whoops, you know, they whiffed the slide and got full combo punished. If they don't wake up, it's still fine. Like, you can poke them or do kind of what you want. Start up strings if they just, like, tech roll and block. So I think that's one of the best things about Deceptive. It kind of closes their options really well on the slide knockdown. And since one of the biggest things that actually hits people, like it especially at high level, forward four slide probably has like a 90% success rate on hitting somebody. You have to be someone who's really guessing that Reptile's actually going to do that and actually commit to going down and blocking it and full combo punishing him. Of course, it's full combo, but if you think that Reptile's going to do 4-4 slide and then it just so happens that that's the time he mixes it up, that's the time that he does 4-4-1-2 and he just goes into his normal block string, then you may be eating a little over 30% meterless. So, you know, it's not always the best idea to just do 4-4 slide by itself. And you just got to mix it up, you know, really got to mix it up. Melina, though, this is a bad matchup for Reptile. The reason why I say that is because she can zone Reptile really good, of course. She can go under all of this stuff with her roll. And also, she has really good punishes, of course, to a lot of the stuff that he does. She's also just a great character in general because her damage is great and her strings are awesome as well. Back one two, the back one two is, come on, man, stupid, so good. Round two. This guy had a lot of wins too, but it doesn't feel like Melina is his main. We are lagging super bad. This is like your captain speaking. We're at 200 MS. So you can expect a lot of turbulence. That's pretty much what happened here. Caught him out of the, I think he was trying to do dagger in the air. Oh, bad trade. Oh, see, there it is. That's deceptive pressure. Typically gets people. Oh, he's randomly throwing the armor out, which some people do whenever they're invisible. They like to throw the armor out, so if you're holding block, then you can really bait out a lot of armor by not doing anything. Simply just like walking back and forth and tapping block every once in a while. That's all I did. I just like stepped back, I held block, and you know, an armored move came out, and then it's like, well, there you go. He just wasn't ready for a Reptile to be kind of patient like that. Special J, 3,000 wins. What? This guy is one of the best. I wonder who he plays. 3,000 wins.
Reptile.
Come on. Oh. Okay. And he's got the cool costume for her as well. So that's good. But people cry about Cassie, you know they do. They cry about Cassie nerves, even though she's fine. I'm sure she's fine. Like I used to play a little bit of Cassie because Gross played her, and me and Gross, you know, we're boys. We're Green Lantern boys. And he was like, dude, play Cassie. Play Cassie because her back one is like Green Lantern's back one. It's like super good and fast and great for whip punishing. and I said, like, well, I would, but Reptile's my favorite character. I'm gonna always play Reptile. He's like, I have to play him. I can't help it. I played him since I was, like, in kindergarten, so I'm gonna, like, Reptile is like, that's like, I don't know. It's like family trademark. Like, I have to play him. And sometimes he's bad, sometimes he's good. In this game, he happens to be maybe mid-tier. It's very hard for a Reptile player to make top 8, of course. No Reptile players have made top 8 this year, so I mean, good luck. We're trying. It's pretty difficult. Okay. Yeah. Well, this guy, maybe Cassie's not his main, I don't know. For as good as his record is, he doesn't really understand the spacing of Cassie at all. Ooh. See, I can do, I went meterless. I didn't get me the bar, whatever. Yeah, he didn't, I don't know, Cassie must not be his main, he's just messing around.
Reptile wins.
I could play Cassie. I played Spec Ops, and I played a little bit of Hollywood, of course. I didn't really mess with Brawler, even though I hear Brawler is good, and Brawler apparently has some stuff. I never really got into that. Does it always... Justin, I swear I'm gonna play with you as soon as I get done eating. Hopefully this isn't taking too long. I'm just trying to make sure that I stream long enough to where it's actually worth people's time, you know? Like, I'm just gonna maybe do it for 30 more minutes or less. Like, 20 to 30 minutes and I'm out. 1,000 wins for this guy. So you know he's pretty good. Walk.
Takeda.
Oh no. Shirayu. Oh wait, Ronin. Okay. I'm a little more familiar with Ronin. I really do. I want to play against Shirayu more often because I think that just overall, I think that's the better variation. But the other ones still have some stuff, of course. They're still really good.
Round one, fight.
Let's see what this guy does. Oh, wow. Starting off, maybe he thought I was going to jump towards him or something. I am known for doing that. I definitely do it. Oh, wow. Missed a convert. Okay, this guy is kind of eat up by Reptile pressure. This is just basic Reptile pressure stuff. He, you know, has made some bad decisions from the start, so that was hard to come back from. But now, look, he made the smart decision by keeping all of his meter. So now with this meter, maybe he can really make something happen. This is what Takeda players like to do, though. Like, if you're zoning them out too much, they like to jump until they find what they think is like a window to do the flip out of the air. And a lot of times I can time it right to where I throw a slow force ball out and they end up just falling right into it. See what I mean? Like they're gonna try to do that. Good reflect. Fell into it again. Too bad I couldn't get the same amount of conversion, but it's all over. Yeah Justin, I want to play just a little bit longer, just so that there's a lot of people that wanted to see this stream. They wanted to see the Deceptive Boys stream. They're really just like people that follow my YouTube page. So, I don't have as many followers on Twitch as I do on YouTube. Like for some reason, my YouTube is a little bit more popular, and my Twitch is like. You know, it just goes to show, like, you gotta be consistent, you gotta stream often enough for people to actually care, and I don't do that, for sure. So, yeah, you got it. Yeah. You wanna play? Aaron Black. Yeah. So the Aaron Black matchup, usually lower level Aaron Blacks, this consists of him sliding. We're gonna see a lot of slide, possibly from bad ranges. But oh nice shooter. There's a slide. That was actually a really good slide from there. And I'm not blocking low for the sand grenade. Oh, I know why. 200 MS. Okay. I try a lot of times, like, if you don't see me block something, it's because I'm trying to, like, get some spacing and then block it at the last second. Like, sometimes I want to step forward and then low block, but really, like, nothing came out and it just got hit. So, we're going to deal with the zoning here. Figured another zoning shot was coming, so didn't get a full combo punish here, unfortunately. Reese's delivered. Alright, so I didn't get the full combo punish from the slide, but it's okay because there it goes. I knew it. Slides will be coming out again. There's another one. Oh, slide, here you go, full combo punish. Why do Aaron Blacks do this to themselves? I'd love to just slide and slide. There's another one. Can't do it from full screen. There we go. This is the business. Breaking it, lagging it out, unplugging his router, doing everything he can. Oh, another slide. Come on. Another slide. You don't need to do it. It doesn't have to be like that. That's just typical Aaron Black, though. Like, lower level Aaron Black, especially when they see that many force balls on the screen, they want to slide. They want to get under them and they think they're really going to make something happen, but space them out correctly, keep them full screen, and it's, you know, not going to happen. Well, just got a Reese's delivered. Special delivery. Got a bunch of people at my house today. I never got any feedback about Sonya. What do you guys think? Do you at least think that Sonya is like top tier? Or close to top tier?
Faction battle.
You do. You think that.
Aaron Black.
Another Aaron Black, okay. Joel is about to be full of chocolate. So this is Marksman, though. The other guy was Gunslinger. For Marksman Aaron Black, the difference is he's going to try to zone some, but it's going to be like worse zoning. And he's got some cancels in the pressure. So let's see what he does. Okay, got opened up by 4-4, gonna throw him full screen. This is typically what I want to do to Aaron Black. I'm fine fighting Aaron Black from full screen, especially these guys that just want to slide in. Again, see? Slid right in. I wasn't exactly ready for it, but it's not good. He's got plenty of meter, let's see if he stays on it. Oh, I was ready for a slide to come out, but he didn't do it. Here. Oh, I wanted to compete with this slide. Yeah, see, you can poke the pressure from Marksman. You don't even need armor. You can just, like, poke out of... Oh, you messed that up somehow. You can just poke out of whenever he cancels into the rifle to swing it like that. To, like, golf swing it. That's, like, the time to cancel. Ooh, good block. Strange steal. A brave man, for sure, blocking a 4-4 slide. Oh, yeah. Oh, there's a slide. He's getting whip punished. Why do you do it? I was blocking the wake-up window again, just in case. Oh, yeah. Slowly step back. You see me walking back slowly. I was thinking, here it comes. Here's a slide. It's going to totally change the tide. And he's dead.
Reptile
wins. And he's mad. Super salty. As usual. And you shouldn't be. It's just Mortal Kombat X. It's all guesses. If you lose, you just guess wrong a lot. It's no big deal. Now, if you lose in Street Fighter, normally you're getting outplayed for sure. Like in Street Fighter, it takes a lot more skill. Mortal Kombat, although it does take skill, I'm not saying it doesn't. There's a lot more things that don't really come to fruition with practice. It's really like you can practice up quickly. You can get these mix-ups. Trust me, they're going to hit people because people have to guess. And that's it. Like, you know, you got these really good, meaty, mid-normals. Like a character like Alien, for example. So Alien, he has like 4-1. And that's a mid that's really good, great range. And it goes into like a lot of strings that you can change between overhead and low and mix it up. Oh man, something must have logged out on the Facebook. You can really do a lot with that. That's like all Sonic Fox did at Final Round. It's just 4-1. Like every time he's starting up something, it's 4-1, 4-1. And from there you do like 4-1-3 or whatever, 4-1, 3 mix up. Like you could do the low tail whip or the overhead flip, and when you burn meter on it, you get a lot of damage. He's just a Alien's just a great character. He's still, I think Alien is still top tier, even with the nerfs, and there weren't really much. There were just small adjustments that put them there. So Unbreakable Sub-Zero, being played by Scorpion Black. Oh man, he's laggy. He is rubber banding all over the place. Oh man, good stuff. I don't see that normally. I'm gonna have to watch for that. If he's gonna wake up with that and just expect me to keep pressuring him, I'm just gonna hold it. I'm just gonna wait. I'll just block and then let him do that, and then I think I can whiff punish it. I'm pretty sure. Slide. Oh man, I had a feeling he might slide, but you never know who you're dealing with. 4-4-2. Slide. Oh, I knew it. See, he thought I was going to continue pressure. Now he's, yeah. Just in case he did anything, I was like, you know what, you're going to have to deal with this. So that's what that was for. Easy. 4-4-4-1-2 slide. Dash up. Meter run invisibility. You know, they wake up, they get punished. If they don't, you'll see a lot of people just sitting there. They sit there and they don't understand, like, you know, whoa, he's invisible. And like, should I try to press something? And by the time they actually like process it and then try to press something, they're already getting hit by like 4-4 or like a poke or whatever. Like you're jumping over them and then they're like pressing a button and getting jump one'd. That's probably what Chris G would do. Chris G, he does like the worst deceptive stuff. He's so behind on the tech. Like Chris G will do like 4-4-1 meter burn invisibility and then like try to jump over you and do something else. And like you can poke, there's characters that can poke that. Meterless poke that. Like you won't jump over, you won't even get the jump. Like even before the patch when Reptile was more plus on invisibility, if you ran up to somebody and did 4-4-1 invisibility and then tried to jump, you could get poked by Kotal. A 6-frame poke, it's easily gonna poke you. Or if you weren't comfortable with that, you could just do like, you know, wait until he was on the other side and anti-air down one, or you could even like neutral jump punch anti-air that, because you're not at very much advantage at all from 4-4-1 meter burn invisibility. It, even when it was good, it was like not that much. But he got away with it. He would do 4-4-1 invisibility, jump run on the other side, and punish people, or and open people up that way. Rooster, we got Ermax, Master of Souls. Yeah. Oh no. He did. Oh, back dash. This is you, Harry. This is your plan. Oh, you got good converts. That's pretty good. Oh, caught me. Oh, stutter. I'm not gonna let that. Stuttering happens so often like that. Not without catching some armor occasionally. Okay. Yeah, I know what you mean. Like, just a lot of great damage from Ermac, and I think it's worth, like, it's worth the risk. You don't really need meter for combo as Ermac. So, if you don't need meter for combos, what do you use meter for? Well, you use it for a breaker.
Yep, like, breakers in my, that plus level, you know, little shock ball thing that you use sometimes. To get you off.
If you watch Big D won't use his overhead very often. He'll only use forward four, like, typically if he has two bars a meter. He'll do forward four soul ball if he has two bars a meter. And if he doesn't, then, like, he just likes to still, you know, frame trap and stuff.
Because four is just, like, overhead itself. Okay.
Yeah, so forward four is overhead. It's like overhead into soul ball for this big 40% combo, and if it got blocked, then you just break.
Okay. It makes sense. Yes. That's stupid how some characters are like that. And then you have other people who can see it for me.
I know. It's fair, right? Sonya gets free 50-50s. The damage goes up into the 30s easily. For free, they're safe too. By the way, they're safe.
I don't know why. Yeah. You know why there's two extremes like that. Either you have 50-50s and they're like hella punishable, or you have 50-50s like Sonya and they're just safe.
Well, Melina's really good too. Melina right here. Let's see. SOS Zula. SOS. I wonder if SOS is like a real clan that is popular. Oh, nice wake up. Yeah, I like to see if people actually know to input their wake up on the other side. I guess it's too late in the game now. People know enough about Reptile. They know that he likes to dash over you as a combo ender. Like, slide and then Reptile and dash over.
So risky.
What, the ball right there? He did? Yeah. Yeah. I hope that was an input error. Ooh, bad trade here. Yeah.
With the
they don't card, right. I don't know her strings actually, but I do know it's mainly lows. Like, you can react to the overhead that she has, and then, like, other than that, it's like lows. Like, her strings have like all lows in them, and at some point in her strings, instead of doing it, like, say the second hit's a low, instead of doing that second hit, you just like do an overhead ball roll. And that's like how they really open you up like that. And then plus just like back one, two stutters, back one stutter. Like, it's the spacing that she has with that move in piercing is so good. I think, is piercing the only one that has that string? Or do they all have back one, two?
Yeah, I have it.
Okay. So piercing has like the zoning, like the good zoning mixed with that great string. Which I think is the most, that's like a very well-rounded variation to use as Melina. Like, you probably want to fight most matchups with piercing. Not to say that there isn't a reason to use Ethereal or, what's the other one? Ravenous, that gives you the health? Mm-hmm. There may be reasons why you use Ravenous. Like, maybe a particular matchup you can do it. I don't know. Like, you can get more out of it.
Yeah, that's the one.
Oh, okay. I didn't know that. So it's got some like real thick throw setups and stuff. Yeah, that's good.
Oh. Not to mention, you also have.
Yep. He's in. Can't come up with the name. I'm trying to zone him a little bit here. It's like he's gonna get zoned out because he's just you can't not like when you are at a life deficit and you think it's a good idea to start a zoning war, it's not. Like, just sorry to break the news to you, it's like not a good idea to start a zoning war, especially if the other person has like 50% more life than what you have. That's not gonna end well. If they know what they're doing. Like, if they're an idiot and they're just like trying to come in on you, then like maybe you can cheese them out, but players that know what they're doing, they're not gonna just sit there and be like, well, you know, I guess I have to come in. I got this life lead. I guess I have to come in and deal with your stuff. Like, no, it just makes some trades and win the match. Like, finish it up, right? Like, it doesn't seem like that hard of a concept, but a lot of players don't do it. It's not that hard to grasp. Even players at like the pro level, they will get caught up in doing something like that, and they'll lose matches for it. It's like it's a mental thing. Questions. All right, man. This is gonna be like my last match stream. I see some of you guys are tuning out. I'm getting hungry. I need to get something to eat. Jackie, I've got text messages. It looks like Hector called me or something. So I got some business to deal with, and I've got food, plenty of other things. Hope you guys enjoyed the stream, though. This is going to be my last match. I'm just going to try to beat this. What did this person pick? Jackie?
Round one. Fight.
Okay. Nice. NJP. Okay, at C, this is one of those cases where it says it's 60, but it's definitely lagging. It's definitely not feeling like a 60 connection. Ugh. Could have punished better than that. Should have started pressure. Jackie's not one of those characters where you basically don't want to take advantage of the slide too much, even though you can. You want to actually work your way in the right way. This is so bad. What a match to go out on, huh? It's alright. Like, whatever. I'll beat him. I'm gonna win still. I'm just gonna. Come on. Text Mike. I'm gonna text back. Stop doing reptilian dashes into the block. It's just so tempting because he's not punishing him. there's the flip. He blocked it. Looked like he knew it was safe, but he tried the fast one back. There's the force ball. Should have done the fast one. That would have been better. Fast force ball is better on knockdown for Jackie. That way, like, in case she does try to wake up with, like, a tech roll into the shot or something, alright. But, yeah, like, if she tech roll, do the shots or whatever, she'll get hit by a fast force ball. And then you get a really good trade. Alright, this guy's got plenty of meter to turn this around. He could win this, but I'm gonna try to win this match. This is the last match for the stream. Gotta win it, guys. This is for everything. This is for the World Cup. MKX World Cup. Oh man, I tried to down three, so I got hit. That's a really fast normal. Oh wow, the clutch. I don't know what he was thinking there with that. Oh man, not something you want to do in grand finals. Wake up X-ray, dropping combos, no way. That's gonna be enough. What are you doing? Jumping back, going nowhere, bro. All right, guys, thanks for watching. I'm gonna get out of here. Hope you enjoyed some Deceptive. I'm definitely going to be playing it a lot more. Now I'm going to start streaming, doing matches with all the variations, not just the same variation the whole time. So maybe it'll be better. You guys can see like all variations like all day. So, yep. Whoops. Get out of here. All right. See you guys.